All right, guys, so from now on, we will be using the Canvas app. We are no longer using ClassLink to get into Canvas. It is not working correctly and I keep having glitches, so no more using ClassLink. We're only using the Canvas app. On this page, I have the Canvas app. It's the only app on this page. It says student underneath it, and when you click into it, it's going to ask you to find your school. So if you click find my school, I want you to type in Azel, and then Azel ISD is gonna pop up right there. So you just gotta click that, and then you're gonna log in. So your login, your username is your lunch number, and your password is SC hashtag, and then your lunch number, your lunch number again, and then you'll click log in. All right, so once you open up the app and you've already logged in and found your school, you're going to click Simpson Homeroom and Courses, and then it'll pop up my home page. When you get here, you're going to click on Friday, and then you're going to scroll down until you see, click here to access today's work, and you're going to scroll until you see Friday. Here we go. All right, so we're gonna work on decimals, and we're gonna make it bigger. So if you click this little arrows in the top, it'll make the whole assignment bigger. Okay, so you should have already watched the lesson video, and then right there I'll have the assignment explanation video, and then we have all of the assignment. This is gonna be way different than we've ever done it, so I need you really focusing. Okay, you're going to take a screenshot of this, and you do that by holding the home button and the lock button at the same time. It takes a screenshot, and that screenshot goes, if you didn't know, it goes in your photo. So we're gonna go open that real quick. Now, to get back to Canvas from here, just double click your home button and click Canvas. Okay, so now let's open up your math manipulatives. If you click on the website, it'll open it up in a window, and now you have your manipulatives. So then double click your home button and go back to the app. All right, finally, let's open up the assignment answer sheet. This right here says hundreds chart assignment. Click to open answer sheet. This is where you're going to record all of your answers. So your parents have the option to print this out for you. So if your parents printed this out for you, you can do it on paper. That's perfectly fine. Do it on paper, and then you can take a picture and you can submit the assignment. That's perfectly fine. If you would rather do it on the iPad, I'm gonna show you how right now. We're going to use this later on, so even if you're gonna submit it on paper, please watch this video because you're going to need it. So in the top right-hand corner, you're gonna click this little button that has the little marker on it. And over on the left-hand side, it has like a text box so you can type. But we're not gonna type today. You can drag it around. We're not gonna type today, so we're just gonna trash that. But you'll need that for probably later. But you're going to click the marker, and you can like change the thickness or the color, whatever you want. But this is where you're gonna record all your answers. So if you double-click the home button, you'll start here and you'll read number one. So determine the amount of each amount of money below, and we have to put it in decimal form. So number one has a quarter, a dime, a nickel, and two pennies. So if you need to, you can double click your home button and go to your manipulative. So it's got a quarter, a dime, two nickels, and a penny, I believe. Let's go back and check. Double click home button, quarter, a nickel and two pennies. Okay, so let's delete this. And two pennies. Okay, so I see it represented with my money right here. So if I double click my home button, I'm gonna go back to Canvas in this PDF. Now I'm going to scroll up and go to my first thing, and I'm gonna color in just like I did in the lesson, however much I need. So that's colored in, and then above it I'm gonna write, this is not the correct answer by the way, I'm just gonna write it in decimal form, just like I taught in the lesson up, like right above it. If you want to scroll in, you can color it, and if you scroll back out, it'll stay colored in that section. So if ever you need to scroll in or scroll out, you pinch. So to move out, you pinch it or you pull your fingers apart. That's how you do it. So put your fingers on there and pinch, and that is how you're going to get it to zoom in and zoom out. But anyway, so then you're going to go back. You're going to look at number two. You're like, okay, well, it's got three dimes, two nickels, and a penny. So I like that. I like to use the manipulatives. So I have three dimes. What was it? Three dimes, two nickels, and a penny. So three dimes, two nickels, and a penny. All right, so now that I've seen it like that, I'm going to go back into here. I'm going to color in all of the things, and above it, I'm going to, you know, write whatever the decimal form is of that. And same with number three, and same with number four. Make sure I can read it nice and easy. I'm just writing, you know, random stuff on here, but you'll actually have some answers that you come up with. So the hardest part of this is you're going to have to double click your home button, and you're going to have to go between the manipulatives and your screenshot to do the assignment, but it's not that big of a pain. I did the whole assignment, so it's not too bad. So if you ever accidentally click the back button, no big deal, because if you click back into it, it saves your work automatically, so you can do that. There's also an eraser if you want to erase anything and you don't like the way it looks or something. So now you're like, okay, how do I submit this? So in the top right hand corner, there's like a little arrow, and when you click that arrow, it's going to pop up and it's going to look like this. You're going to click the Canvas student app, which is like that little red dots one. And it's going to ask you for comments. You don't have to put any comments except for, you know, like, hi, Ms. Simpson, or whatever. And then it'll say, down here it says course and assignment. Well, that, you know, that's the correct assignment. And all you have to do is click submit. And now I have the hundreds chart. I have what, you know, I have your assignment. And you can click that. And you can work on comparing and contrasting regions. So I will be happy to help you guys any way that I possibly can. You can just get on Google Meet. I know this is new and it's different, but I think it's really going to help you to learn this, because we're going to be doing a lot of assignments like this from now on. All right. I hope that you have fun.